March is National Nutrition Month, and this year's theme is good for you. A healthy diet, that's everybody's goal, right? But culture, COVID, food fatigue can sometimes make dinner a downer. Here to pick up our spirits and perk up our appetites is award-winning dietitian Sue Ma to share two of her favorite recipes with us. Good morning, Sue. It's good to meet you.
Good morning, George. Thanks for having me on the show today.
You know, just before we get to the recipes, and they're awesome, many of us have hit a wall more than a couple of times during this pandemic in the kitchen, right? Trying to come up with stuff that's interesting and healthy and resist the temptation to press the easy button of you know, delivery or fast food and junk food all the time. So that's where you come in. Let's start with this first one. It is a spicy soup, and it looks good.
It's a spicy red lentil and Havarti soup, and I've teamed up with Ontario Dairy to make this today for Nutrition Month. So I love this recipe because it uses all of the ingredients that I always have in my kitchen. Carrots, celery, potatoes, onions, red lentils, and milk. And you know, cooking with milk adds so much nutrition like vitamin A, vitamin C, protein, and zinc. So I sent along a little video, and I'll walk you through how to make this recipe because it's so simple. So what we're going to do is we're going to add the all the vegetables, the carrots, the potatoes, the celery, the onions, give that a stir. Then we're going to add the lentils, and this adds fiber as well as iron. Adding the chicken broth, and now I'm going to add 3 cups of whole milk. I like the whole milk for creaminess. There's vitamin A to help maintain our vision, vitamin D to help support our immune system, protein to give us energy, and also zinc to support a healthy skin. Give that a stir. When it comes to a boil, you cover it, let it simmer, and then you puree it. You get this beautiful red lentil soup. What I've done is I've added some grated cheese on top of it and a little bit of cilantro for, you know, for some garnish. Yeah.
Sue, before we get to the main course, I'm going to just pour out some here. You sent some ahead, so I'm going to pour a little in this bowl.
Yes.
And we're going to try it there. It looks delicious. It smells amazing. A little Havarti.
Well, the curry gives it such a beautiful, warm fragrance.
And a little cilantro.
Right?
I'm going to give it
cilantro.
A quick taste test here.
Give that a try. Now, it's so easy to make, and many of us have these ingredients in our house anyway. How does that taste to you, George?
Oh, my God, Sue. I could put this on everything. Oh, it's so good.
It's delicious.
And so simple
and
to make, as you said.
For you. So simple. You can find the recipe on my website, nutritionsolutions.ca. But to learn more about the nutrients in milk, go to whatcantmilkdo.com.
Okay, now let's get to Sue's Lucky Chicken Lettuce Wraps, the main.
Yes, they're lucky because they use lucky ingredients in the Chinese culture. So chicken for prosperity, lettuce for good luck, orange vegetables like carrot because orange and red are happy colors. So for this recipe, all we're going to do is cook up some ground chicken. We're also going to mix it up with some carrots, some onions, and some water chestnuts. And the water chestnuts are actually a vegetable that gives this recipe a little bit of an extra crunch. Now, the secret to this recipe is the hoisin sauce. So I've got the hoisin sauce with the soy sauce.
My favorite.
It's a sweet and salty sauce. It really gives it a lot of flavor. And this becomes the chicken filling. So I know that you have some samples in the studio. So let's build a chicken wrap together.
Okay.
You're just going to put the filling inside the lettuce wrap. Yep. And then what I'm going to do here is just add some sweet pepper, sweet red pepper, and some green onion on top.
Beautiful.
And there you go. It's fun finger food.
Yes.
You give it a try.
You pre-assembled them for us. I'm just going to try one now. They look good. Let's see how
they
taste.
There you go.
Oh, so
that
good,
flavor. It really... And we use hoisin sauce quite often in our Asian cooking. So, like you said, health depends on your culture, your food tradition, your personal circumstances, your age, and your health condition. So, find your healthy for Nutrition Month. Find those foods and ingredients that you love to eat and cook with milk because it's super nutritious. It adds so many nutrients.
Thank you
so
much. And, you know, all this stuff that you got in here is great for boosting the immune system, too, which we need right now. Food is the most important slow-release drug we ever take, right? So thanks again. So real quick, we're running out of time. How do people reach out to you for more?
NutritionSolutions.ca to find these recipes. What can milk do to learn more about the nutrients found in milk?
Awesome. Dietitian Sue Ma, thank you. Hope we see you again soon as I finish your delicious wrap. We'll be right back.